log footages look like this, and we want to make it look like this. You want to color grade your log footage, bring back the contrast first. Press and hold the Option key, click on the clip, and drag it up just on top. Release the mouse first, then the Option key, and now you have the same clip on top of each other. At this point, you just need to change the blend mode to soft light or overlay if you want more contrast. You can also adjust the opacity to refine the effect, but that's the first step if you're working with a log footage. Actually, this entire group of blend modes right here is used for contrast purposes. I learned about these things doing graphic design and editing pictures in Photoshop. Just a quick note, video is just a combination of a lot of pictures within a time frame, so there are a lot of similar techniques that you can use for photo editing and video editing. But getting back to the overlay blend mode, what it does is it brightens the brighter part of your picture or your clip and darkens the darker part. So it increases the distance between the tones or brightness in your clip. Guys, the reason why I'm spending some time explaining this is it's one thing to know how to do stuff, but it's a whole other thing to actually understand what happens when you do what you do. It unlocks possibilities in your brain. So look at this black to white gradient palette here. Right in the middle is what we call 50% gray. You can see everything above that is a brighter tone and everything below is darker. Let's put it on top of this clip right here and let's change the blend mode to overlay. You see this middle part right here where the 50% gray of the top layer was. That's the only part in this video, in this clip, that didn't change. Everything else got brighter or darker. You guys can see that, right? That's what the overlay blend mode does. So when we duplicated the same clip and changed the blend mode to overlay, we kept the midtones intact, if you will, but increased the contrast. The soft light blend mode does the same thing, but in a more subtle way. Soft light is the baby overlay. Right here, we have the same duplicate clip, but let's change the blend mode to soft light so that you guys can see what I'm talking about. And there you go. Like I said in the beginning, you can always play around with the opacity to adjust the strength of this effect. Once you have your footage back with contrast, you can start color correcting and then add a gray. I'm gonna leave some video up here to help you with color correcting and color grading. With this shot, I decided to desaturate certain colors, and you can do that with the hue saturation curves adjustment. You can just use the color picker and choose the color you want to desaturate or you want to just tweak and play around with it. And this is the final look that I came up with. Now, some of you might ask, why shoot in log if we're gonna bring back the contrast anyway in post? Why not just shoot in Rec. 709 with contrast and color, right? Well, you can do whatever you want, but log allows you to retain as much information as possible and also takes away that in-camera digital sharpening that doesn't look really good. But again, do what's best for you as long as you continue to create and be productive. That's it. If you guys get any value from this one, subscribe and check out these other videos about color correcting and color grading. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.